How to identify whether you're making any progress with your GMAT and GRE prep? How do you know whether you're moving in the right direction? How can you evaluate your learning and feel confident to book that exam date? We'll answer all of these questions and discuss many more things in detail in this video. Welcome back to my channel. I'm Madhuri, an ISB alumna, a management professional, and a consultant for everything related to academics, career, and self-development. If you are someone who is keen on pursuing higher studies, rising up the career ladder, or even developing yourself on a personal level, then my channel is for you. Subscribe now for pro tips and unbiased views. And don't forget to click on the bell icon to get notified when new videos are published. Today we are going to talk about the progress tracking part of your exam prep. When you decide that you want to appear for competitive exams such as GRE, GMAT, getting started with your studies is the most difficult part. If you need guidance with your study plan, study material, and overall strategy to be followed for GMAT, I had covered it in a lot of detail in my live masterclass on GMAT exam strategy. The recording of that masterclass is available on the link mentioned in the description box. After watching that recording, if you feel that you need guidance for your specific case, you can book a one-on-one consultation with me via the link mentioned in the description box or write to me on Instagram. Once you start your studies for these exams, the trickiest aspect is to track your progress. Wondering what makes me qualified to talk about this and why you should be listening to me? This video will help you understand that. For now, let's get started. The first approach to track your progress is via practice sessions. Solve questions in blocks of 10 and check your accuracy. If you get 5 questions right, then your accuracy is 50%. For 7 questions, it will be 70% and so on. When your accuracy consistently comes out to be 80%, start timing yourself for these questions to improve your speed. For reading comprehension, you shouldn't take more than 6 minutes for a small to medium passage and 8 minutes for a lengthy one. For critical reasoning, the average duration should be 1 minute 45 seconds per question, and for sentence correction, the average solving time per question should be 1 minute and 30 seconds. So when you're solving 10 questions in a block, give yourself 15 minutes to cater to all 3 types of questions. Now, why do I say all types of questions? Because it is important that you solve a mixed bag of questions. In the initial days, yes, it will be fine to solve reading comprehension separately, then tackling critical reasoning, and then sentence correction. But when you're tracking your progress, it's important to solve a mixed bag of questions. Meaning, don't just solve 10 sentence correction questions in a batch or 10 CR questions in a batch. It should be 10 verbal questions in a batch with a time limit of 15 minutes for all. Tracking your progress across this batch solving will give you an idea of how much you have progressed over time. If you feel that things are not going as planned and your score is not improving, even after doing everything right, write to me via Instagram or via the contact form on my website. Both the links are mentioned in the description box. The next way to track your progress is to give as many mock exams as you can. In the initial days of your practice, go for free mocks that are easily available online. You don't want to waste the good mocks at this stage because you're not fully prepared for the exam yet. Save those good mocks for a later part of your prep when you will want to do a fair evaluation of where you stand. So for now, which is the initial stage, just go to Google and search free online GMAT mock tests. A number of links will show up. Just click on any link and start solving. Some mocks might be sectional mocks, meaning they will only have either verbal questions or quant questions. Sometimes they will have both. Some others might be mini mocks, meaning the total number of questions per section will be lower than that you will see on the actual exam. Ideally, you should be giving these mocks at least once a week. I recommend starting on Sunday. Now, when you're giving these mocks, as far as possible, don't skip the AWA and IR section specifically for GMAT, because let's face it, you're not going to be taking out time specifically to practice these sections. Quant and verbal will take priority more often than not, and rightly so. The mock exam is your chance to keep in touch with these additional sections, because even though they don't affect your overall GRE score out of 400 or your GMAT score out of 800, the sectional scores for analytical writing and integrated reasoning are considered equally important in the admission process, so don't neglect them. Now, when you give the mock exams and you see your score online, and this is especially possible during the initial days of your prep, you might feel sad if you get a low score. You might even start doubting your prep. So here's what I want you to do. If you see a low score on your mock when you haven't even completed your full syllabus, avoid getting demotivated and shift your focus to correcting the course instead. Analyze your mock in detail and figure out which type of questions you got wrong. If they are from the topics that you haven't even studied yet, then tell yourself that you are yet to cover that topic and move on. But if the questions that you get wrong are from the topics that you have already covered, then note down your mistakes. Keep track of where you are going wrong with each mock and revisit the basics if need be to strengthen your understanding. Analysis is the key to correct course right from the beginning and stay motivated throughout. Let's say even after repeated practice and revisiting your basics multiple times, you're still getting questions wrong. You feel that you know all the concepts, but your score is still not improving. When that happens, I usually recommend my mentees to opt for personal tutoring, because understanding concepts is one thing, but applying those concepts to get questions right is a whole different ballgame. In the personal tutoring sessions, we'll sit down and solve questions together. I'll analyze your approach, see how you're solving questions, identify where you are going wrong, and teach you techniques to get answers right. If this is something that you feel will help you in your prep, then reach out to me on Instagram via the link mentioned in the description box. We'll discuss your concerns and take it from there. The next approach to track your prep is gamified learning. Having gone through the process myself, I know that traditional exam prep can get a little bit tiring at times, and it can get difficult to keep track of how much progress you're making on a daily basis. EdGames provides a fun and engaging way to test your exam prep. They have various levels of challenges set up in a gaming format for GRE and GMAT, with the difficulty level rising across each level. How you score on each of these levels will give you an insight into where you stand in terms of your prep. And what's even more interesting is that you can do a face-off with another participant to see how well you are actually doing compared with the other aspirants who are also preparing for their GMAT and GRE exams. In this gamified approach as well, making a note of the kind of questions you get wrong and covering that concept during your practice will help you a great deal. Check out EdGames website via the link mentioned in the description box. Did you find these suggestions helpful? Let me know in the comments. If you would like my guidance with your GMAT GRE prep or any aspect of your application, including your essays, SOPs, LORs, or even mock interview to help you prepare for the next stage of admission, then please write to me either via Instagram or via the contact form on my website. Both the links are mentioned in the description box. I have also pinned these links in the comments for your easy access. Don't forget to hit the like button, share this with your buddies who are also preparing for competitive exams. Subscribe to my channel for more helpful content and share your experiences of implementing these ideas in the comment section. Here's wishing you all the very best with your master's journey. Prepare as much as you can, stay calm, and give it your best shot. I'll see you in the next video. Thank you for watching.